Bonjour, bonsoir, and welcome on JCB Live, dear friends. The weeks of Thanksgiving and prior Thanksgiving, with Chef Rafa is always the excitement. You know what? One, because Rafa has a great hat, and this is how good he looks. You could see he could go and see Dita Von Teese, and this is how he was dressed for Halloween. And number two, because it's the time to celebrate with major wines. And I'll tell you in a moment about Domaine de la Vougeraie, both the Vougeot Premier Cru, Clos Blanc, and the Clos de Vougeot. But before that, we have two side dish. How do we call it?
Well, we're gonna make gratin.
Aha, Dauphinois.
Dauphinois.
So gratin Dauphinois, dear friend. So you're gonna go back to really the 1780s. The 18th century, back in France, in a beautiful town of Orléans, which is very close to, obviously, Paris, where the kings used to live. And with ortolan, that famous tiny little bird which used to be allowed, similar to partridge, but even smaller and very delicate. In fact, to eat it these days, you have to be hiding your head. So you probably have seen all the tables, very fancy. It's like caviar from the sky. And they eat it hiding themselves. They were served a very cool layers of potato called gratin. So in French, gratin means gratter, to scrape. And Dauphinois is from that region of Orléans, which is a combination of a beautiful cream and of course, this incredible Gruyère and Comté cheese. So this is a lot of fun because the gratin dauphinois is a beautiful side dish that everybody's gonna love because it's obviously, you know, potato, and it goes with every single wine. So I'm gonna let Rafael start.
Okay.
And show off his beautiful gratin dauphinois because it melts in your mouth. And as I start to tell you about the Vougeot, then that's the dish you're gonna wanna have. So here is your little mandoline.
The mandoline, this is a French mandoline, right? Why do you call it French mandoline? Because it can do so many different things. And there is pretty, it's really nice piece of equipment, believe it or not. So this is how the blade close. And then I have some, let's see. I have some sliced potatoes ready to go, of course. And then I have some potatoes. I'm using chicken gold. You can use russet potatoes, anything you want. And this one, the, you just gotta slice them. Paper thin, of course.
That. And the cool thing with the mandoline, you adjust it here. So yeah. You can absolutely adjust the thickness.
So yeah, this one is the blade. And this one, if you put a little clip right here, then I can do, shred it, right? Like this. And you get a nice crispy, you can do crispy potatoes.
For your French fries.
Right, for your French fries.
So you gotta buy a mandoline. This is coming from France. It's in stainless steel. And if there's one thing every chef recommends you have, this is the
this is it. And this is the other piece of the hat. The other piece of hats too. This is adjustable. That one you do right, right there. See, that way you can do the gruffet.
Yes.
You do the gruffet. So this one you should go and alternate.
So this is how Ruffle got the idea of the chips. When we talk about this phenomenal chip that we all love, here it is.
That it is right there.
So it's been made thanks to this beautiful little mandoline. Voila, look how gorgeous it is. Maybe we should have French fries too.
Oh my
Let's
goodness.
Be totally excessive Let's do
it.
Today.
So this is it. I'll show you this real quick. You learn something, probably something new. So is I. So for the, I'm gonna make some bechamel for the potato gratin, of course. But before I need to make the sauce before I can build this, right? It's one or the other, right? So I have about 5 cups of milk simmering and milk and cream.
Yeah, show our friends.
Right? And what I did with this, I put cloves around a half of the onion. So you let it simmer so you get a nice flavor of the onion and of the cloves. And at the end, what I'm gonna do is just, you know, toss it. Throw it away, or compost, whatever. So that's that. This one. Now we're gonna go back to the fire. But I'm gonna make the, this has been simmering for at least 20 minutes. Slowly, right? So I'm gonna do some nice, a little bit of butter in here, in my pan. I'm gonna melt down the butter first. About a stick of butter, maybe. Melt it down. See, it's melting quick. I got my preheated pan already. Right? That was melted. I'm gonna add about a cup of flour. You're gonna whisk it all in until they just make, we're making the roux, right? This roux will be perfect like when you're gonna make your gravy from all the drippings from your turkey. So this is how you do it, right? Put the flour, melt and cook down your flour all the way. See? Real quick. Once it's done, cook your flour again, boom, boom, boom. 1, 2, 3, and it's done, right? It takes like what? Two seconds to make the roux. This is how you make roux. This is good to make the bechamel, right? Right, now you added it, right there. That goes all in as your cream. And it's gonna, what it's gonna do is gonna thick it out. And this is the same process for you on a biscuits and gravy and all that stuff. That's the same, you gotta make your roux first, right? But we're gonna cook it for like, until they start getting thick. 2 minutes in, and literally you're gonna see the cream and milk changing. It's gonna start getting thicker and thicker.
Mm-hmm. And as he's doing that, dear friends, let me tell you a little bit about the Vougeot, Clos Blanc de Vougeot. This vintage is miraculous. It's the 2017. Fresh, crisp, vibrant, and luminous. Think the 11th century. And this is why it's perfect for Thanksgiving, to recognize the past, honor the past, and be grateful about the past and thankful about the past. This wine is the first Chardonnay in the Côte de Nuit of the heart of the Grand Cru. This is the diamond among the rubies. This is a small plot, Monopole. We're the only one who owns it. So we're very honored about that. And we have a big weight on our shoulder because the wine has to be the example of what Chardonnay in the Côte de Nuit is about. And this is a small production, only 12,000 bottles produced. And I'm pleased to tell you, this was the Altamont wine of the monks. So in 1110, early 12th century, when they planted this vineyard, it really became the iconic vineyard of the entire region. And Rafael loves it because all the sins he does, whenever he drinks this wine, they are forgiven. Yeah. So he has to drink it every day because what a delicious. Bad boy. Remember, this is the side dish, right? This is the side dish. Is it how we call it, Danelle?
Side piece.
Oh, Danelle, side piece. Julia, is it side piece?
It's definitely side piece.
Ooh la la.
Ooh la la. So this is my side dish with my side cream. See, now I put the root in, it's nice and thick now. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna start adding the cheese. We did a blend, of course, with Comté and Gruyère.
Wow. Comté and Gruyère.
And Gruyère, yes.
So, you know, one is 32 months of age, the Comté, and the Gruyère is 6 months. So one is very tender, and the other one is salty, richer, and more zingy in a way. So the two together are perfect marriage to create that amazing and really quite incredible.
And this I'm gonna do with a French twist. I'm gonna add some egg.
So there's many ways to do the gratin. We're going Dauphinois. There's a gratin Savoyard. For many of you who know the distinction, the layers of the potatoes have a little bechamel, but Beaufort. The Beaufort cheese, which comes from obviously Savoie. And this is as well very, very good with an amazing Jura wine. Maybe an Arbois, or eventually, if you want, a yellow wine, a vin jaune. And this is typically what is served with this dish. So Savagnin as the grape is absolutely a miracle. So you know, gratin has evolved over time. My mother makes a beautiful broccoli gratin, an amazing cauliflower gratin. So you could use gratin as a recipe, the base, with any vegetables you like, because the whole point is to add that richness to a vegetable which typically doesn't have a ton of taste. Why potato is so great is because what you add as a side piece mm-hmm. to it, whether it's mustard for French fries or ketchup and salt, whether of course it's the dauphinois or the cream. I mean, when you see this, this is gorgeous. Oh, the smell is magical. And I'm glad we have 18 people tonight because this is quite...
How does it taste?
I would add salt, a little salt.
And you know what my secret
yes.
ingredient is for this, believe yeah. it or not?
I think it is. What you put on a gin fizz?
Crème fraîche.
Oh, crème fraîche, of course. But Danelle, what do we put on a gin fizz, which is great? The famous nutmeg. So if we have a little bit of a nutmeg.
Let's do it. Oh, yes, yes, yes.
I would
yes.
recommend the nutmeg because that add that taste profile that is magic. Mm-hmm. Let me taste. Mmm, very nice.
I'm going to do about a tablespoon just because John should say that. And yeah. they really neat.
And I'm going to put on the Clos de Vougeot Blanc.
I'm going to do about a teaspoon of nutmeg.
How do you pronounce it?
Nutmeg.
That's a Middle Eastern
what is that?
Accent.
What is what?
It's brand new. Maybe he's turning to be from Catholicism to Muslim. But we love it. We want to integrate all religion.
It's nutmeg?
Nachmach.
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 Now, pepper, salt to finish. If you don't want to put a lot of salt because it has a lot of salt, the cheese is salty. Mix it all in.
So the trick of the nutmeg, like in the gin fizz, it's going to add something that not many people do, and some of the best recipes of the gratin dauphinois does it. And you talk about the best restaurant in the world. I've always attempted to master gratin because the layers melt on your palate, and for us making wine, this is a dream because this is kind of the perfect side piece companion. I need to tell you, I got the definition from Danelle and Julia.
Yes.
What is a side piece? I had no idea. God, perfect. Languages.
Go.
Nachmag.
So now we have, now we can do a little bit cheese in my baking dish, right? A little bit chizo.
So now that's the cool part because we're gonna lay it.
Now we gotta layer, you know? Layer out.
So you need to be very meticulous on this one.
Oh yeah, if you wanna like really, 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 really nice, then you take your time. But mine are gonna shrink the potatoes a little bit.
And which I love with the mandoline, you see, 1 millimeter. So you make right. them nice layers so when you cut it and you have your beautiful meat mm-hmm. or obviously your turkey or
turkey.
Anything you do, mm-hmm. it's not too thick. Because there's nothing more frustrating to put too much in your mouth. One, it's not enjoyable, mm-hmm. two, it's not that polite, and three, it's not that attractive.
Exactly. So she's gonna build it real quick. And if you wanna take your time, you do layer by layer, cheese, I'm gonna do layer, cheese, layer, cheese, layer, cheese.
So as a child, side note, dear friends, we all had tasks. I remember 6, 7, 8 years old, my mother would say, layer the potato, and it was exactly the same platter here. That is the best to put in your oven because you can look as it's on the oven how it is.
It's baking, all getting all the nice caramelized
color. And now we add a little bit of this.
No, not yet.
That's not yet. You don't do layer by layer.
Then we do more cheese. Uh-huh. More cheese, right?
Here we go.
More cheese. You know, as it bakes, all the cheese melts again and it goes all the way to the sides.
So we do this again and again?
And again and again until you finish all the way up. This guy probably takes us all day. We'll be back tomorrow.
So Rafael, we are not done. Do you think we're done?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm going to show you a little trick.
Really?
So dear friends, the gratin dauphinois, the whole idea as well is to cook with what you have in the winter, from the potatoes all the way to a variety of cheese that you want to actually enjoy all together. So you take a little bit of the bread that has become a little harder because obviously, you know, bread dries. And then I'm gonna use The next one, we're gonna try the Clos Vougeot, just to make it a very nice breadcrumb. Nothing better than Clos Vougeot to help us to do that. See, in the old days, my grandmother didn't have a pastry roller. She was always using an empty bottle of wine to do the crumb. So I'm thinking of her, but I'm doing it with Clos Vougeot, which is the extreme excess. So now, you see, we have the crumb, and Rafael, you're gonna love it because look how cool it is.
Whoa.
You see, it really works. You see, it really works, and you put it, and we're gonna put it all on top. And it's gonna add a great little layer, a little bit of crunchiness to the top. You see, here we go. I'm so glad I could teach you something for once. Yes!
Wow.
The crumbs will make a big difference.
He's taking over. I quit. Bye.
Well, so this is a beautiful one.
So that's gorgeous. Now, this is going to bake for at least an hour. We're going to cover with foil. Then we're going to pull them out. We're going to pull them out and cook it for another 15 minutes so they get a nice crust on top and a nice layer that we're looking for. Right?
Perfect. Let's go to the oven.
Let's go to the oven.
So another amazing side piece, Rafael, that is your own recipe, is the stuffing.
The stuffing. Turkey stuffing. And it's one of my favorite things ever as a side dish for Thanksgiving. And like I say, this is one of my favorite recipes. I've been making them for many years. And this is my own secret and my own twist.
So are you going to share that secret?
Absolutely. You know, all the recipes that I work so hard to put them all together and tweak them out, make them sexy, you know, and easy for everybody to make it at home.
So we're gonna make sexy stuffing. Mm-hmm. I look forward to
this one. So this one, made my own crouton. Make some, did a little bit of cornbread.
Yes.
And all, you know, croutons, you can make it with any stale bread. That's the beauty of making this stuff. It's like same thing if you gotta make a bread pudding, and you can use.
Well, as you heard bread, it. You know? A few minutes ago with the gratin.
Yeah, with the gratin. So this one is like I said.
So is yours with dry raisins?
It has, no, this one actually, there's many recipes out there, they use raisins. Mine, it has dry cranberries, right? So that's what I'm using for this.
Because we have enough raisin, of course, in the wine. So we didn't want competition between what we're gonna put in the bottle
exactly.
And what we're gonna put in the stuffing.
So for the, I have a preheated pan already, and I have a mirepoix. Mirepoix makes of onion, carrots, and celery, right?
That's the tedious work. Mm-hmm. This is a lot of work to do.
Yeah, I mean, if you want to kind of like take your time and cut it, but these days you can buy them at the store ready to go.
But this
right?
is very healing to cut, mm-hmm. isn't it?
Yes, yeah.
This is like me pruning the roses.
It's either you're going to have the scales with a knife or you're out of the hospital that are having dinner with your family. Anyways, but I hope everybody enjoyed my recipe, and please make it if you can. So I have about 2 cloves of garlic, and I'm gonna saute my pan with a little bit of grapeseed oil from Oakville grocery, and I'm gonna put about 2 tablespoons of butter.
Ooh, look at that. The butter is the king. And dear friends, at the meantime, I decanted for the last hour and a half our wonderful Clos de Vougeot. So this is, as you all know, the most well-known Grand Cru in fabulous Burgundy. I was born from those two vineyards, the Clos de Vougeot Blanc and Clos de Vougeot, 500 meters, 400 yards away. This is really my dream wine. So when we think about Thanksgiving, we gotta pull out the top guns. So this is our Passion Collection decanter that we designed, very reminiscent of the 18th century. As you can see, the beautiful shape, the see-through for reds, and the stripes for the whites. So you could use the same decanter for both the Clos de Vougeot Blanc and the red, and I recommend you carafe both. Why? Even the younger it is, a Burgundy needs to be open to the air to break out the molecules, to bring out the flavor and all the aromatic expression of the wines. You could see we have a diamond cut. You could see the sun comes through and brings light to the liquid, as well as a beautiful top that is reminiscent of the open top fermenter where the grapes ferment in the wood fermenters of Burgundy. In fact, this oval shape that I have here is reminiscent of what the monks used to cultivate in those open top fermenters. And Fabulous Dylan is going to show now a few pictures, as you could see now in front of you, of those famous open top from Burgundy. Very unique, tailor-made specifically for this wine. So as you can see, it's a very simple fashion to carafe wine. It looks beautiful on the table. And you serve the guests very gently. You know, as you can see, it's a very easy decanter to hold. Two fingers here. If you like the right hand, here. And you have a very thin funnel, which barely fit one small finger in order to really manage very well the flow, so it's very elegant, as you could see. Looks very refined, very elegant. The liquid comes in and obviously will breathe over a long period of time as well. So I think the idea of Thanksgiving, the idea of cooking, the idea of celebrating, the idea of receiving family and friends is to make a celebration as well of the theater of the table. And it's not just theater, wine needs to be decanted. I'm part of that school who really believe air benefits the wine. So, Rafael, would you be so kind to all our friends?
Yep.
Thanksgiving is coming. Oh, the earth of Burgundy, the soil, the richness. The intensity, not the flamboyance, but the austerity of the depth of the wine really centers your thoughts. And this wine, I really believe, brings everything together. One of the top Pinot ever. Remember, Clos Vougeot is very small, 166 acres, 85 different owners. We luckily own a large piece. This wine specifically for Domaine de la Vougeraie is fully organic and biodynamic, and we pushed it to even introduce horse plowing to really be the steward of the land and manage compaction and life in the soil. And this is why I really believe this wine is magical. It was first introduced in the 10th century. So it's been 10 centuries in that specific terroir and clos, which means surrounded by walls, that has been making such level of Pinot Noir. So dear friends, stay in Vougeot, be with me, and let's celebrate the whole way with the white wine of the Clos Vougeot and the red wine.
Beautiful.
Salut. So Rafael, what else?
I have all the veggies sauteed, ready to go, of course, with some butter, salt, pepper, and I did have sage. Sage is gonna give a very good flavor, aromatic. It goes very well. Sage, I like to put the sage right before I throw my veggies in, so it like activates the nice and aromatic flavor of the sage. And of course, right after I throw my garlic in and your vegetables, and then you just cook it down a little bit. And this is what they should be ready to go. Just remember, you don't want it to like cook too much because it's still gonna bake, you know, bake it in the oven for at least another 20 to 30 minutes.
So not fully cooked.
Not fully cooked, no. You want a little al dente, you know?
You see, the Italian is kicking in.
Mio!
Oh, here we are.
And then I have some chicken stock.
All right.
Yes.
You've added. Oh, dear friends, amazing flavors in the kitchen today. Mm-hmm. Wow, what did you add to it?
I added some nice garlic. Veggies, carrots, onions, thyme, a little bit of rosemary, sage, and all that to get like all the richness flavor of the chicken stock. And of course has to be like, I did a little bit of the dark chicken bone to do it. I mean, of course, a lot of this stuff, you have to like take, Thanksgiving is all about having fun, enjoying cooking, but you don't want to spend 20 hours cooking in the kitchen, right? You can find this one in the store, buy in the store, the breadcrumbs you can buy in the store, of course, if you want. I make my own because this is how I like it. That's how I like
it. Yeah, but there's other ways to do it and it still tastes good.
It tastes gonna be amazing. It's probably even better.
So when do we put the cranberry?
Fire up.
Now?
Todo.
Yes!
Todo.
I love cranberries in the stuffing. And you know why I love them so much? Goes they very, very well with Pinot Noir.
Now she's gonna have my chicken stock. It's nice and rich, thick, with all the nice herbs that I put in it. It smells good. Mm-hmm. That'll go in some. And you don't want it to put too much, but of course you want to let it sit a little bit because you want the bread to soak all the good flavors and the stock. So we don't want it to let it sit for too long, otherwise it will get soggy. You don't want it. Run just enough, incorporate everything. You see in the bowl, you can see all the still. It's kind of what you're looking for. It probably needs a little bit more. You can add it as you go. Boom. Adios.
So how do you know when to stop?
It's just all about feeling.
Yeah.
About the feeling.
But you don't want it to float in it.
No, you don't want it, no. So see, that's
so the breadcrumbs is basically absorbing the liquid.
Absorbing all the liquid, yes. See?
Oh, fabulous, man.
And that's it.
And that's it?
Yeah, we just gotta bake it.
Wow. Mm-hmm. So how long now?
This is gonna go in a baking dish for at least, I like to cover with foil. Again, you cover with foil, bake it for at least 30 to 40 minutes.
Yes.
And then pull it out and it's
so and good. I understand the modern technology allows us to show you now, 40 minutes later.
40 minutes later.
We are back now.
Here is the wine already, it's already been processed, baked.
I have great news. The wine is so good. This is what remains of it. Rafael and I have been cooking. So we are 40 minutes later from this magnificent moment of the oven that allows us to really go and have a glass of wine. So there's a lot of things you could do in those 40 minutes. Talk to your friends and be with your family and just enjoy life in general and do a little wine tasting.
Yep. So now, 45 minutes later, John Charles is cooked, ready to go. And also we have the potato,
wow.
The potato, this is the other one.
Looking so gorgeous, both.
Gorgeous. Now it's time to play.
So, isn't it fabulous to be thinking of Thanksgiving? And I think even though this year has been a challenge for everyone, and has been a reinvention, for all of us, has been really rethinking who we are as individual, what we do, where we're going. I think it's important to celebrate and appreciate. We know there's many people who are not in the most fortunate situation because of what they've lived, of what they've encountered. But at least let's use this moment to be thankful for all the life we have before and the great life we have ahead. And remember, we can change the course of our life at any time, as long as we want to. And I think it's important to say is this end of the year, I always do my resolution, I write them, I don't always apply them, but at least I put them on paper because I always want to be thinking about the next year and what's coming. So dear friends, as Rafael and I are sharing with you those beautiful dish, gratin dauphinois, Rafael, and your beautiful
stuffing, gorgeous.
We wish you all an amazing time, great thoughtfulness, a lot of fun, and think of others that are not as fortunate as we are. Let's pray, let's enjoy life, and let's celebrate life and be thankful.